Hi, welcome to Styx 2 Shards of Darkness. We're doing mission to Khorangar. First, let's have a look at the SP available. 765 SP, we might pick up another 15 if we beat the 20 minute marker, we'll see. Skills that you'll need: absolutely persistence, feline, and latency. They're all very good. They'll allow us to use invisibility for a bit longer. In alchemy, you'll want poisonous bolt. We need at least one bolt and at least one lockpick, although you don't need craft lockpick. I've gone all the way up to Vagabond's carry all or something, which lets me carry more stuff. And if you want to get greed, if you can afford it, in extended vision, there is no harm in that either. So yeah, that's pretty much all the skills you're ever going to need. There's like one more. Is there? No, I think that's it, pretty much. Cloning is kind of interesting if you ever want to play Master. I'll get stuck into that. But yeah, you can see I've got zero iron ore, zero raw amber. If you don't have a poisonous bolt, or enough poisonous spores for a bolt, there are four up there, which is pretty handy, and there's so much iron ore in this level, you're going to be absolutely fine. So anyway, come around here. If you want to get those poisonous spores, you want to jump across here and head up those grab rails on the right hand side. That's it. Climb, climb, climb up to the right. I'm actually going to reload after this because it throws off all the patrols afterwards, so you might want to farm them somewhere else. I'll explain where some of the patrols can be because they can still vary in their timing from playthrough to playthrough. It's kind of interesting, I prefer it. It's less rote. It's like there's less guarantee if you hit X at this second, then everything will be doing this. Anyway. That's the way you go if you want to get the poisonous spores. If you don't, drop down here, grab this guy's amber. You can't get the amber if you get the spores. I've got one bottle of amber starting this level as well, and I think like zero raw amber in my thing, which seemed like a reasonable start, right? Anyway, first token there. Then drop down here, fire invisibility as you fall, grab the second token off the table there, roll into the darkness, deactivate invisibility as soon as you can. You shouldn't need more than 3 seconds of invisibility. So don't waste it, then climb on up this rope and head down this way. This guy here on patrol, basically you want to wait for him to be over this side. He might be wandering around elsewhere. You can also unlock this door that we're going to unlock when he is praying, when he appears to be looking at the door. You can do it then as well. This guy won't see you while you're unlocking the door, but look up to the left with the guy who was praying previously to turn around. There we are, and then come in here and open the door. Once that's done, roll through here, grab those two things there, and then there's another token here. I think that's token number 3. Yes, it is. Now, there's a few ways around here, but I think this is the most efficient. I kind of toed and froed. It doesn't really matter because you're not going to make swiftness anyway, but there's this chap's got some amber on him. Then double back, jump onto this block and onto that grab bar above the door, and over the top, get your poison dart ready. Careful, don't jump up too quickly, otherwise the guy on the left will see you, and maybe the guy on the right will too. Wait for the guy on the right to start walking, then put a poison bolt in the guy on the left. Steal the amber off the table. Falsify the register. There we are. Grab that out of the window, turn around, wait here for this guy to move on, then grab the token that is in front of him, then carry on around here. Now careful when you climb up here. The chap there can sometimes be standing on the wooden board, and if he is, he will see you the moment you climb up, so take your time. Be safe. Then follow this chap around, grab the token there, watch out for the guy who's out on the balcony, he's coming in now. So make sure you jump into the dark. If you walk across, you're likely to be seen. Now up here you can be a little bit cheeky, walk right behind this guard before you activate your invisibility, then run down here because you've got silent running, and deactivate invisibility. Hopefully the chap in there should go yellow. Doesn't really matter, then just run out here, use the rest of your invisibility. Now we're going to go back to this wooden board, and you will see what I mean about him standing there when you climb up. If he is standing there, be really, really careful. Don't come up even to the second grab point. Just wait for him to turn around. I was going to use a diversion item, but you'll have seen he already turned around anyway. You can also just use invisibility. We're going to be completely full of amber at the end of this mission. We're going to break into the amber storeroom. Anyway, carry on up over here across the rope, drop down, we're going to get token number 7. There we are. We also haven't got a pass yet, but that's okay, we will swing back for it with the last 3 tokens, or other tokens, 8 and 9. Try not to fall off there, that was a pretty special move. And then come up and over this way up the stairs. You can activate the signal thing first before picking up all those things if you want. I'm just doing a save here because you've got a whole bunch of options here. Basically, we need to get the pass to what's her name. So you can wait here. And the safest way to do it is to jump onto there if you want to go down this way. And if you've already got the other tokens before you've come up here, you can do it this way too. You can also walk off and grab onto the side there and you won't take damage. But you can also go this way. And we'll come back and look at the way across in a minute. But you can climb up here and go around, and this avoids the guards completely. Jump up and over here and then up there. There we go. And then across here and then take the rope to the right. Then it gets a little bit tricky here. So just hold off the edge here and then let go. You've got to make sure you're on the right, otherwise that guard there on the left will turn around and see you. Then get ready to drop down there and use an invisibility. The other way to do it is here, come around to the left and just jump that gap and those two guards won't see you. And you can just run through here and you take pretty much the same route. I had a bunch of different plans around here, but I kind of figured the most badass way was to do this. So roll off the side and grab on here. Then you're just going to wait for this thing to arrive. It takes some time. I was really hoping you'd be able to grab onto a rope halfway down somehow, and I tried a bunch of different methods. I tried so many ways to grab. Like, I know you can get the top. That's the way we're going to go. But, yeah. If anyone can grab a rope, let me know. I don't think it's possible. But you basically, you come across here, you can land that without grabbing on the side. Run down here, roll off the side onto that ledge, and then drop off here. There you go. If you grab onto the ledge first, you won't lose health, but it will slow you down. Try not to grab onto that, just make a clean jump across. And then come around here, make sure your amber is at least 4 bars. And then you're going to run up here, activate your invisibility, steal the pass, turn around and just roll this way. And as soon as you're out of the light, start rolling and you should be absolutely fine. Now run across this gap and do a running jump onto the boat or the airship or whatever, roll around the back or run around the back here, give the pass to Helidryn. Then we're going to go grab the other two tokens, so jump up here. The two guards will split left and right, which allows you to just walk up over here, make sure that they are not around anywhere and that they're not looking your way, and then just drop around here. And then you can start running as soon as you hit the wood. Come up here and then sneak up behind this guy. Now, I made a real dog's dinner of this the first time, but just watch out. There's a chap up here who will sometimes see you. You'll see him on the right there. Just be careful you don't pull all the way up, otherwise he's likely to cause an alert. Anyway, jump across here to grab token number 9. That was token number 8 just before. And then around here, there's some grab bars. So drop down and climb your way up and to the left and up and left and around. There we go. And then just swing your way across here. You might want to climb down on the last rope just a little bit. It can be done without, but it's a little bit risky. You sometimes bounce off. There's an insect egg down the side as well if you need it. Anyway, jump in here. The final token's just here, so grab it off the side. And then you can do a roll to the left and then a roll down here because it's all carpet. And another roll and open this door, and this will take us through to the next section. Check you've got 10 tokens and haven't triggered any of the bad things. Okay, coming up here, you want to do a jump across here. There are 5 tablets to find, I think. So come up here. First of all, they're all marked pretty obviously. Although with the guards up, it's a little bit tricky to get. This guard as well has got some amber on her, so grab that or him. I don't really know the difference between the girls and the boys. They're all kind of slender. Anyway, a few treasures in there. We've got some pretty rich pickings on this mission. We come away with like 12 poisonous mushrooms, I think. 15, 16 iron ore, maybe the same in raw amber, I don't really remember. But there's another token, that's number 12. And then go out of this window and onto the roof, and then you're going to drop down here for 2 more iron ore. Now, I fluffed this. You can actually climb up here if you want to, but then I realized that was a route that I'd been taking from an old practice run before I found a more optimized route, so this is the way you actually want to go. Just straight back through this door. This brings you in here where there's an insect egg, and then you can climb up into the rafters and poke around all these rooms freely. There's a poison mushroom through that one, then you can go into this room here where there's a tablet or a tile or whatever they are, first one. The thingy there, unstable spore and another poisonous spore, iron ore and a token in there. Now straight back through this room, don't miss that iron ore, and then we're going to jump back up here, head out of the front. There's a little ledge there where you can get up onto and then come across here. Now, make sure that you've got 3 tokens and 1 tile at this point. Then save quickly, because that happens every time. And then jump up here, and then around this way. You're going to jump across here. That's really annoying. You should be able to clear that jump without those being there, but it latches you onto them every time. Anyway, through here, take a right, not a 270-degree left like I did. And then across this rope, if you climb for a little bit at the end, you can jump all the way up onto that ledge first time. Then open that door and into here. There's another tile on this table, so we're just going to use some invisibility. Remember, I started with 1, and I think we've got 2 in the bag at the moment. I missed the prompt. But uninvisible under the table. I didn't quite have 1 bar left for another invisibility, unfortunately. It's just shy. But it's okay. We're going to have loads of amber. Grab some sand if you need it, and then wait for this soldier to move, then grab a token just outside here. There we are, token number 14. Yes. You can actually stand up there anytime. It doesn't matter if the guard is looking at you. But as soon as she moves, you want to make your way through there. If you want to blow an invisibility, feel absolutely free. You've got enough amber. Then we're going to wait for that guard to clear and drop down here to get token number 15. These start to come in pretty thick and fast at this point. There's 3 in this section, along with 2 tiles before the balcony. 2 more tiles. 1 more tile? How many have we got? We got 1, so 2 more. I got a little bit lost here. You actually just want to go into that room I was in and through this window. And then not that way, but around to the left. And then under these rafters, you can run along here. And come up, and you'll just be by another token, which then leads us to a tile. Watch out for this chap on patrol here. And then rush through this door. Oh no, it's tile first. The tile is on the desk there. And then if you take a left, there's some amber on the right and some amber on the left just before you go through the door there. And then we've got to gain some height, I think. Yeah, we do. We've got to go up a level to get a token. So the easiest way to do that is to go back into the room we came in through and then go through here and get onto this rope. Now the jump up here is really tricky, and I realized when I was watching this back that it's also completely unnecessary. You can just walk around this corner, but you'll see here if you jump too early, you'll bump off the ceiling and you won't gain height to grab onto the roof. But actually that guard is looking over the fence, so it would have been fine. But I jump up here and grab onto the roof like that and then drop down here the other side of the guard. Sometimes the guard is already walking towards you, so you kind of have to do that, but have a look, and if you can sneak around quickly, then do. There's 2 poisonous mushrooms there and a token, and this guard's got a health potion on him. Or it's not really a guard, is it? It's a civilian. And then into this room for a few goodies before we make it to the balcony. At this point we should have 3 tiles and 16 tokens. I think I'm going to bring up the menu in a second here. There we go. 16 tokens and... Nope, not going to look at the tiles. but yeah, there's 2 more through here. Head to the left and grab onto these grip bars, then across here. I didn't realise you could grip onto that for the longest time. Then I tried to put a strategy around it and finally realised the quickest way is just to open this door. And then jump up, grow through that crawl space. There's a tile number 4 there. Yeah, there we go, 4 out of 5. A token, 1 jump away. Some raw amber, 2, or iron ore, 2 jumps away, but I completely failed to pick it up. And then 3 jumps away. There's a mushroom. Then jump up here and head back through, drop down, jump up, and onto the roof here. Now, there's a guard patrolling on this bridge, but don't worry too much about him or her. She's really never going to see you. There's some iron ore there that you might want to grab. I didn't actually mean to grab onto that. I'll show you what I did mean to do after grabbing the iron ore, to land there like that. And you see that guard's nothing to worry about at all. Then jump across there and just crawl your way around the corner of the building. There we go. Drink some amber. We're going to need to go invisible in a second. Open this door, go invisible, stay standing up, steal that, and then run down here. As soon as you get under the desk, you can lose your invisibility and pick up that token. Now here I rolled too early and caused a ruckus. So instead you want to grab the token and the amber if you want, and then stick close to the wall and roll very late, and then grab that token there. Sorry, it wasn't a token on the table, was it? Anyway, regardless. Over here we have got another poisonous mushroom, but I'm full of them already. I think I came in with 10. So that's 10 we've picked up already. That makes number 11 there. Plus the 4 at the beginning, which I missed. So that's 15, I guess. Then you can drop down here. Now you want to get up onto this first slab and then jump behind the statue. Not like that, don't fall off. Here we go. And then once you're clear of the statue, start pushing left and you'll grab on there. Then you can climb up there and just jump away. I fell off by accident, but if you just jump, you'll be absolutely fine. Then come around the side of this pillar, hug the right wall, tuck in here, and then aim across there and roll, and the guard behind you will go white, possibly yellow, but as long as you're quick and keep rolling, you can see he went yellow there. He's not going to come up and investigate. Then drop down here, and we are into opening the amber store. Number two is, if you push two, then three, then two, then two, then two, but the tablets will give you clues. The numbers are on the ground. Number one is flame, number two is death, number three is roaches, number four is war, I think, or orcs, and number five is flame. But remember, they're not numbered 1 to 5, so use amber vision to work out which number's which. Anyway, down here there is all the amber you are ever going to need, so refill, whether it's 3 or 5, you should be in good shape at this point. Then we're going to head up this way, so straight up and out over to the gondola. Don't miss the token in there either. I picked that up pretty quickly, but there's one down there on the altar on by number 5. But then crawl your way around here, watch out for the guard who's patrolling, he shouldn't be a problem. Save there, it's easy to miss this jump. Save again. For some reason I never get this, I freaked out there, but I never get it when I'm crawling. I don't know why, I always have to be standing up for a longer jump, but climb up a little bit before you do the full swing, otherwise like me you'll bounce off the wall and won't get the grab. But jump up there and then jump up here, slide down and then take a left to the exit, and we're out. There we are, just broke 20 minutes, yay. But that should get you, what do we say, 965 plus 15, so about 980 SP for that, depending on how much you had before. On the left is Mission 1, Revelations, and on the right, Mission 3, I don't know what it's called. But that's it for now, I will see you in the next video, lots of love, bye.